Well, I want to talk a little bit about the planetary alignment at the pyramids of Giza. Was it a dud or was it not a dud? And I don't, on the surface, think it was a dud. I'm not somebody that was expecting the earthquakes to happen. Could have happened, I don't know. Normally, when we have the lunar perigee, when the moon is closer, I think that's something to more pay attention to. But this is a little bit freaky, in my opinion. Well, also, like the middle planet, the middle pyramid, the highest pyramid is going to be lined up with the planet Venus, the planet of love, and also you have Mercury, planet of communication, and Saturn. I don't know what Saturn is. It has rings. It might have got rings from the planet of love, Venus. I don't know. It's probably an STD for all I know. But anyway, I'm not, I do have some good information here, but the thing is, there's just too much coincidental numbers and dates with this thing to ignore it. It could signal the beginning of something. And I also want to correlate that with something else I picked up on from before. But December 3rd, 2012, the progression of the equinox takes exactly 25,920 years. Keep that fact in mind. December 3rd, 2012, the three planets lined up at the pyramids of Giza: Mercury, Venus, and Saturn. Now, the big date is going to be not 12/21/2012. That's the end of the Mayan calendar, the end of the age, and all this type of stuff. There's 18 days. Now, some say 18 days, that's 666. I don't know. But there is, in these 18 days, there is exactly 25,920 minutes, which is the same number of years that's in the progression of equinox. That's pretty interesting. So, we're supposed to go through the galactic plane on 12/21/2012. Now, I'll tell you one part, people, the Tibetan monks, and I actually displayed this before, the Tibetan monks are taking this very serious. They're actually warning people that it's going to be darkness for a couple of days. I don't know. They maybe don't know what the hell they're talking about, but maybe they do. Maybe they know more than anybody else does. I don't know. I know there's a number of people in Russia that are taking this serious, even like in the United States. But actually, the Russian authorities are actually getting, I don't know how prevalent it is, but there's a significant number of people that are getting out of the cities, making preparations because of the 12/21/2012 phenomenon that's coming up as a precaution. It's probably a smart thing to do. I think the average Russian that's doing that is not really stupid for doing that because you never know. You never know. It could be correct. I also want to point out that, some of these things, like I pointed out that Illuminati clock countdown to 9/9/2012, a lot of people thought that was a dud. It wasn't. It was not a dud. The 9/9 countdown clock to the Illuminati. Just like we're looking at this 12/3/2012, it's probably not a dud. I'm not thinking it is, to tell you the truth. Then, to give you a correlation or an analogy, the 9/9/2012 countdown clock was turned out to be not some kind of catastrophic explosion at the Paralympics ending or some garbage. It turned out to be the release of the movie Muhammad. And that movie Muhammad, interestingly enough, was originally produced as The Desert Warrior. And it had completely different dialogue being uttered in it. It didn't have anything about Muhammad or Islam or anything. Turned out that they dubbed in all the voices and the actors' lines later on, with about insulting stuff to Islam and Muhammad. Then they released it into the Arabic world and on 9/9. Then 2 days later on 9/11/2012, 11 years to the day after 9/11, 2001, Twin Towers, the Benghazi attack occurred. Interesting, right? 11 years later, also on a Tuesday, the day of Mars. Now, considering that there are people that I'm pretty much convinced. Now, I can't look at every single 11 day of the month and worry about it. I'm not worried about any of this crap, to tell you the truth. And this whole deal with 12/21 could turn out to be another Millerite big disappointment, because like back in the 1800s, if you remember the Millerites, they could be almost like in comparison to the Tibetan priests that are actually saying there's going to be something coming up here. The Millerites back in the 1800s believed that the second coming of Christ was going to happen. And it never happened, right? It was, it was called the Great Disappointment. And of course, they became the Jehovah's Witnesses, I think, of after that, if I have that correct. Also, if you remember back in May 2011, you had Harold Camping out there, the multi-millionaire, who was telling everybody, you know, the world was going to end, and he's also making money, I think, smiling to the bank when he was telling people this. What happened? People committed suicide. People lost all their possessions, and the world did not end. So, you know, I keep a thing of my eye out for this, basically. You know, I'm not going to totally discount it and get caught blindsided if something happens, but then again, I'm not going to worry about it either. But I do find it very interesting, and it's some of the freakiest dates in the world just seem to coalesce. It's like 101 days from 9/11 to 12/21, 2012. And it's, I don't know, it's just, it doesn't happen that much. This planetary alignment of Giza doesn't happen but once every 2,700-something years. I think it was 2,737 years. Pretty interesting, pretty interesting. So this whole deal may not be over with. Just keep a wary eye out for it. You know, I don't think the world's going to end. I think that's bullshit. But somehow I'm smelling, to my sense, you know, what I think may happen. Since there are very important people involved in these Illuminati, whatever you want to call them. There's very important people that are involved in the occult and the numerology and the planetary alignments and all this type of stuff. They may be planning events around this because they believe that it gives those events more power and more strength. So, it might be something to this, even though it looks like a dud. It could be the beginning of something. Or maybe it's something far beyond what, you know, the elite control, you know. That's what I tend to think. If there is something to this, it's far beyond what the elite control. So, you know, or you can just think of it as a bunch of BS, because I know Venus is associated with the planet of love, but it's really just a big rock floating around the sun. Somebody decided to call it the planet of love. I mean, it's fun to call it the planet of love, I guess, you know, but I guess it is. I don't know. We can just make believe it is, you know, but that's just how it is. But this could very well turn out to be something real, because it may be that people will make it into something real. I'm not just talking about people panicking, but I'm talking about important people who believe in this type of stuff. They may plan an event around in December for, you know, because they think it's going to help elevate their power. That's the way I understand it.